Right, we're live. So just started, and if you're watching this stream, of course, after the live feed, please comment, please subscribe and like, and also what you could do is help Ella Skins Going by donating or something like that. I do believe in the description of this video, there should be a link to PayPal where you can give a donation. Now, I've never asked before. I don't like to, but let's be honest. Time is money, supposedly, and I do give up a lot of my free time to upload and make free content, demos, tutorials, just anything really. Simon, right, Simon Cushing, you like the wig. There's a reason for that. Simon, can you hear me all right? I just need to make sure that you can hear me. Can you hear me? I hope you can. Yes. Everyone can hear me? If they can, yeah, you can. All right. So the whole reason for this video is this live stream, and I want to get people involved. Thank you. Is what the heck is going on with the music industry? All right. So before, okay, before anyone asks any questions, so don't ask any questions yet, please. What I wanted to explain to you is, you know, certain aspects of what's going on at the moment, and I'm not looking at the chat now, so I'm just talking. So please don't give me a question until I say, because I won't be able to look at it. But what I don't understand is, you know, the world is on the in this mad place at the moment, and you know, we have big supermarkets being able to stay open and carry on opening, whereas small businesses, small sort of, you know, family-run shops have closed down. We're allowed to go into, in the UK, to a pub with strangers up till 10 o'clock, but you can't have more than 7 people apparently in your house. And if you're involved with the likes of, say, a hunt, where you can go and kill an animal, you can have as many people as you want. But then you can't go out into a field, into someone's private grounds and play music, because you'll get arrested. So what's going on? I mean, you know, let me explain something here. That one of the last gigs I did was at the end of March of this year. And I have, like a lot of you, I've had loads of gigs cancelled. And I mean, like, yeah, all gone, gone. I've got loads next year. They've all sort of put them forward, but apprehensively, because they don't know if it's going to carry on. You know, for all we know, it could carry on and they could just cancel and put it forward again till the middle of next year or the end of next year or 2022. Who knows? Now, last year and the year before, I worked in the Holiday Inn in Telford, did a great job. They loved it. New Year's Eve, and they asked me back this year through December. All cancelled, all gone, finished. Because, you know, what's the point in having a Christmas party if you can only have like half a dozen people in? And then what's the point in having entertainment if you've only got half a dozen people in? And as you know, with most dinner dances, a certain percentage will leave after the meal. You know, not everyone's going to stay. And that's across the board. Definitely not everyone's going to stay unless, of course, you shackle them to the tables. In that case, they're not going to dance. So, you know, I'm finding it very difficult to see how December's going for me. And this could be, it could very well be, for me personally, the first New Year's Eve that I would have not worked in over 30 years. Now, that is, all right, no big deal. But for me, it is, because I enjoy New Year's Eve. It's fun. You know, it's exciting. It's really, it's very easy, but difficult at the same time. It's easy because you play party music. That's what they want. They just want to party, sing, dance, and have some fun. It's very difficult because you need to keep that energy like sky high all the time. If you drop the energy, then of course you drop the feel of the night, and come 12 o'clock, people are like milling around thinking, what the hell has this DJ done? So in a way, if you weigh the balance, so long as you have the right ingredients, which is of course your music, you can't go wrong. But you can if you don't have the right music. So where are you at? What is happening with you around the world? And this is the key here. You know, are you having gigs? Have the gigs been cancelled? How many gigs have you had cancelled? Now, I'm going to try and go through as many comments as I can. Know you have a family as well. You're my favorite YouTuber because you act like yourself. Thank you. I followed you for years, mate. Thanks so much for all your tips. Hey, Master, you're my favorite and I learned a lot from you. Thank you very much. 2021 will be a repeat performance. Yes, that could be true. Hi, Jonathan. How are you doing? I'm doing good. Right. So in August, they were having techno pool parties. May have to go there to get work. Yeah. Oh, my friends, you are the best DJ. Please keep the tutorial vids on tap, please. I'm going to. Is DJing your main career? All right. Well, DJing is my main career, but also teaching as well. And by the way, I'm going to ask now, okay, this video is monetized. So if you like what I do, then donate. Even if it's a dollar, it would be amazing. It would be help. It would help me. It would help the community, and it would keep this community going. So I'm gonna carry on saying that during the course of this video. Why not? I never have in the past. I've never gone, give me money, and I don't really intend to. But you know, I'm giving my time, and what I'm trying to do here is correlate information so in the future we can look back, we can look at comments, we can watch this video again, and we can see what other people have got to say around the world. Love your videos, man. Been watching you for years. You're awesome. Thank you. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a woman. Okay, right. Now, the reason, thank you for taking the time to share your skills with the community. You're awesome. Chase Shadows, thank you. Now, the reason I'm wearing this, all right, there is a reason. Because many years ago, over 10 years ago, I did a video on YouTube, okay, and you can see it, all right? You can Google it. It was a mashup of Absolutely Flawless by The Ones and Casual Relief, Green Velvet, I Want to Leave My Body. And I did that on vinyl, and I wore this, all right? And the song, I Want to Leave My Body, which is on Relief Records, I get it, all right? Because it's almost as though when you're in what you class as reality, part of you thinks, is this actually reality? Is this real? Is this real? What's going on? And you just want to leave. You want to float away. You want to go somewhere. And I get it why people take drugs. You know, I don't say you should. I don't say you shouldn't. But sometimes I actually get it because some people need to escape. My escape is getting on my bike and hacking down the road and doing 50 miles. And that's my escape. I love it. All right. My legs are burning, but I love it. But for some people, it's smoking weed. What the heck? Do it. You know what the thing is with weed? Guess what? You know why it's called weed? Because it's a bloody weed. It grows naturally. So anyone who says it's illegal, I'm sorry, but it grows via Mother Nature. Are you telling me Mother Nature's illegal? I don't think so. Okay, drugs are escapism, yes. That's split for sure. I love cycling. What a great escape. Yeah, it is. Cycling is a bloody good escape. In fact, any exercise is a good escape. And I highly recommend you exercise, all right? You know, I have my bad my down times. I have my bad times. I have my good times. You know what? I'm friggin' human, all right? You know, I'm no expert. I am not an expert on this. I'm not an expert in anything. I am only human. But I like to escape. I like to get out there sometimes in the actually, a lot of times in the summer, I go kayaking. I'll go cycling just to keep fit, just to maintain a sort of a healthy body. Do I eat crap? Of course I eat crap. Who doesn't? Well, some people don't, but I bet you there's everyone out there who'll have a, you know, a sneaky piece of chocolate or a big fat something or other, you know, because that's what we do, all right? But anyway, in general, sport is always good for your health. Makis Kusla, yes. Be brave, some fresh air, and forget about this COVID nightmare that shot down the clubs. Yeah. All right. So, right. So really, this stream is about what the heck's going on. Now, I have a theory here. Okay. Now, I don't want to go over too much just in case, but I have a theory. Entertainment is fun. DJing is entertainment. Going to the cinema is entertainment. Going to watch a band is entertainment. Going to Ibiza to a nightclub is entertainment. Yet all of these avenues of our life have been shut off, practically shut off. So maybe that is part of some kind of plan to close off the enjoyment in your life. Also, not only that, but stop you meeting and greeting people who have the same mindset of enjoyment. Because it's an old saying, divide and conquer. The more you can divide people, the more you have chance of conquering them. The more people are away from each other, the more people talk, can't communicate, and then slowly you drift away, like two boats in the sea. Slowly, if they're not tied together, it doesn't matter even if it's calm water. They will indeed probably slowly drift apart. It may take a long time, but they will indeed. And you see, when you have a rave, you have fun. When you're out there enjoying yourselves in the fields amongst loads of other like-minded people, there's a vibe, there's an energy there. I've been there, and it's one of the most wonderful experiences in my life to go to a rave and sit there and dance, drink a couple of drinks, and have a wacky, mad fun with like another 1,000 people. It's insane. Low House, hello. Hey, Jonathan, it's Michael from USA. All right, Michael, how you doing? Bliblick 21, this is mad, mate. New word order. Yeah, NWO in ready mode. Yeah, so again, I don't want to talk too much about that. I'm pretty sure 21 will be lame. Just hope they let, and that's I am Dobbix. So 2021 will be lame. Maybe, I don't know. By the way, don't forget, please like and subscribe. And of course, if you if you're feeling generous, don't forget to donate, even if it's a dollar. Thank you very much. So what is 2021 going to give us? Well, you see, at the moment now, we're coming towards the winter in the Western world. So will we have more restrictions? I don't know. We may not. But, you know, the nights are closing in. The days are getting shorter. Nights are getting longer. One thing I've said time and time again, one way of clearing your mind, really clearing your mind, is to not watch what they give you out there. Not, you know, that repetitive thing that happens every hour that's on the radio and on the television. The best thing for you to do is not listen, watch, or read it. Just don't. Because that in itself is a soap opera. It's a big soap. It's a way of capturing you. It's a way of getting something inside your brain. And is it the truth? Isn't it? I don't know, because I don't watch it. But what I do know is the truth is when I go out for a bike ride and I'm trundling along at 40 kilometers an hour and the wind's blowing in my face, that's the truth. That wind is hitting my face and I'm going at 40 kilometers an hour. That's real. When I see a tree with the leaves falling down onto the ground, that's real. That's Mother Nature. That is real. I like that. When I go to the beach and I see the tide coming in and I see the shale and the sound of the waves hitting the shore, that is real. But what we have to understand is anything via maybe social media, television, radio, you have to always question, is it real? You have to answer, you have to think, is it actually real? DJ No Maloma saying you're spot on. Max Westman, right, mate. Bass Junkies, lol. Their plan didn't work out because I know I love DJing and I met lots of people online. Grant LA, do not watch the news. Good man. Had an argument in a bar the other day about a mask, and his barmaid said, "Don't you watch the news?" My reply is, "What's wrong with society? People feel we have to." Well, we don't know. Precisely, we don't have to. There are a lot of people out there who say, "Well, don't you watch the news?" It's almost as though, like, you don't watch it. You mean when you get up in the morning, you don't open your eyes? It's like, well, I do, but I don't watch the news. I'm not interested in it. It does the things. It doesn't interest me. And I think that's the key. It's like a drug. You know, if you take a drug, you get used to it. You have to have it. If you stop taking it, you get maybe a bit of withdrawal symptoms, but slowly, hopefully, surely, after time, you forget about it. You don't need it anymore. So why take it? And this is it with the news. Why take it? You see, if they want to tell you something, if they want to give you information, what better way? I mean, what better way than to do it? But there are so many other ways you do it. And I don't want to go down the rabbit hole here. Really, this is about the DJ industry and the music industry. Now, I've talked to a lot of people in my industry, and a lot of them have said, "Got no work, selling my kit. I don't know. I've got to get a daytime job, nighttime job." So how about you? Let's get some comments. Where are you? And are you having to get more work? I'd like you to consider the virtue of end goal, destroying the entertainment industry. What benefit does it have to put over 1 million people out of work, no tax and burden on the system? James Brindle. Okay, now that's a really good question. What's the point in destroying the music industry? Well, I personally feel it is not about destroying the music industry. It's actually about destroying happiness. It's about destroying fun. It's about destroying communication, laughter, entertainment, connectivity, vibe and energy of people getting together in a euphoric space. That is what is being destroyed. That's how I feel. That's what I feel is happening. Because when you get a collective amount of people together and they're dancing, on that dance floor, there's energy. They're making energy. Now, you may be the DJ, you may be playing the music, but the people are making their own energy on the dance floor. So there's a lot going on here. And when you've got that happy energy on the dance floor, you've got smiles, you've got laughter, you've got happiness, you've got strangers smiling at strangers that would never smile at one another in Morrison's, in TK Maxx, in, in Burger King, in Pizza Hut, in Taco Bell. They would walk past each other, yet on a dance floor, they smile, even though they don't know each other. We're losing that. And I think that is what they want. They need to get people to lose the form of communication around entertainment. That's my thought. Hey, Jonathan, you're my first YouTube I subscribed to a long time ago. I have a question for you, if you may. Good songs for Halloween, disco, metal, EDM, cheers. Don't really want to go that over there now. I mean, really, all right, Alice Cooper. Alice Cooper is a really good guy. Go and Google him. Alice Cooper for metal Halloween tunes. You can't go wrong, okay? Hey, Jonathan, you were the first. That thing has put me into work at home, sustain more time practice. Okay, yeah, so there's more time to practice now we're off. The Rona isn't that bad, actually. It's just a little bit worse than the flu. Yes, it may be. I don't want to talk about the vaccines or the Rona or the irises or anything like that, according to people I talk to studying medicine. All right. So, yeah, I don't really want to talk too much about the thing because there could be issues there. Really, this video is about the thing, not discussing it, but how the thing has affected our industry. That's what I want to talk about. Now, for me, it's affected my work as a DJ, a physical DJ, immensely. And I'm sure it has for a lot of people. I do watch online, and there are a few people who got gigs, and they're wearing those muzzles and screens in front of them, and so many people allowed. But that's ridiculous. You know, I mean, You know, if you or I walked into a supermarket, we could bustle around and mix amongst numerous people. Yet, you know, we're not allowed to mix with 50 or 60 people in a bar, in a nightclub. People aren't apparently allowed to dance because they're too close to each other. There are so many issues about what's right and wrong. It's confusing for everyone. And I just don't get it. I don't understand it. I'm getting to the stage where I'm thinking, I don't like going outside to shops because I feel like I'm walking amongst aliens. Everyone's wearing masks. I actually saw a person wear one on a bicycle. I mean, hello? I've seen people wear them in a car by themselves. Hello? I mean, what's going on there? That to me, it doesn't even register. It's like, I didn't see that. Let's forget about it. But it's there in my subconscious. Alice Cooper. Don't forget Alice Cooper. Hopefully, you know what will be said and done with us soon. There's a saying, never leave a good disaster go to waste. And I do have my own theory, but let's just say that the thing is causing money problems, which in turn will cause a financial collapse, which in turn will say, look what we've got. We have digital currency, and then goodbye world. Studying business. All right, so it's madness. Yes. Has it got 21 in it? Okay. Any more questions, really, I suppose, on the DJ thing? How are you doing? So, you know, if you're a working DJ around the world, how is your business doing? You know, have you got gigs? Are they cancelled, forward, back? How many people are you working for? How many gigs have you got left? If you do have a gig, how many sort of guests are allowed to be at the venue? Just let me know. Okay, so Mark Winter, yeah, not gigs since March. I know the feeling, Mark. Mark, by the way, is a very good friend of mine. He's been over here. And like me, the guy's just sort of dumbfounded. XEA, I feel the lot of the music and excitement for it has dried up. Trying very hard to stay positive. Well, this is it. I think you've hit the nail on the head there. It is very difficult to stay positive in this doldrum, because we honestly really don't know where we are. Now, again, I don't watch, read, listen to the news, but, you know, I feel as though everyone's sort of like every morning waking up and waiting for that, right, you can work now, or yes, you can do this, or yes, you can do that. And the crazy thing is that if you think about it, you know, when you're young, when you're a child, you listen to your mum and dad and they tell you what you can and can't do. And then theoretically, when you're an adult, when you become 18 in the UK, you can do what the hell you want. Yet now we're actually in this nanny state where now this big person is telling us what we can and can't do. Well, when did that happen? I mean, when did all of a sudden, you know, this system say, well, you're 18 now, you can go out and get drunk, you can go and kill someone, you can get a gun and we give you permission to go around the world and kill people, or you can smoke, you can drink, do whatever you want. But now we're going to tell you when you can entertain someone, when you can't, when you can do this or that. I mean, when did that happen? That to me doesn't register. I don't get it. So you have to ask, you have to question yourself, you know, where's your freedom gone? You have to ask, where has your freedom gone? And it's been taken away. It's a little bit like musical chairs, where you're all sitting down. So you've all run around the musical chairs, you've all sat down, and guess what? Someone pulls your chair from underneath you, you fall flat on your ass, but you don't question it, you don't argue, you just go, oh, there we go, I've fallen flat on my ass now, and you just get on with it. You don't question who took the chair, you don't question why they took the chair, and you don't even question why did you take the chair from me, but also from everybody else. You just sit on the floor and think, oh, there we go, and get on with it. You see, this is what's happening around the world now. Very few people are questioning what's going on because they're just used to being fed all the information and agreeing with it. Philadelphia, my India label is holding down the hood underground gigs, but that's well dried up, will dry up abruptly soon. While a lot of time to study IAM Dobix, the deepest of music production, and actually got signed up to some songs. Really proud I spent quarantine. Right, okay, so IAM Dobix, well done for you. David Robert, hi from South Africa. I've no gig, so I haven't resorted to live streaming for a time being. Taylor John, my last gig was a legit one. No many made there, however. Okay, Grant LA, do you think it would be easier to get shows when it's all over than before? Okay, will it be easier? Well, that's a tough question, you see, because what you've got is you've got this demographic of people who will be scared for a very long time that they may catch something. And those people are, let's say, from 50 to dead. So, and I'm not saying that, you know, all that age group will say, no, not having any gigs, but then they may be slightly more wary. Now, I cannot see all of a sudden everyone going, yeah, it's fine, right? Everyone walk out, you're okay. Because it will still be in the back of people's minds. People will still think, maybe, maybe not. Should I go out? Shouldn't I go out? Now, again, festivals. A good friend of mine, Mark Winter, helped me with a load of festivals. Well, Lake Fest the year before last and so on. A great festival. I was supposed to be there this year. It didn't happen. Next year, fingers crossed. But even if it is next year, you know, are we going to be in a position where a lot of families may think, I don't really want to go to a festival, even though everything's fine now, because there could still be something around that no one's told me about. And do I really want to stand in a field watching a band with another 1,000 people shoulder to shoulder? So who knows? Now, also, apparently the people at the top are pumping money into the system at the top to keep it afloat, which is sounds great for them because they're making loads of money, but slowly it might trickle down to us. Again, that's going down the rabbit hole. Don't want to go there. Do your own research and you'll see that's actually correct. But you see, maybe what might happen some point in the future is all this money printing, apparently that certain people are allowed to legally do, scratching my head there, may just end up being worthless. And then we could have this complete meltdown. Who knows? So we really don't know what the future holds. But what we do know, and what you know and I know, is that music is the key and we can carry on playing it, whether it to be ourselves, family or friends. We need to keep that light shining, and you can keep it shining by carrying on playing your music, which I'm going to do right now. Now, this one here, No One Above, original mix, Glass Slipper, and this is by Karmic Power Records. Now, again, I play a lot of Karmic Power Records because I'm allowed to. I have a green light from Karmic Power Records to play their music, so I don't get any copyright issues or anything like that. So again, this is one of the issues with playing music, you know, copyright. And you see, if you think about it as well, Facebook recently have stopped a lot of live streams, music. You know, I mean, would I be right in saying that just possibly, slowly, little snippets of the entertainment industry has been taken away here, a bit more there and there. And before you know it, you know, what used to be a circle is now like a small squiggly dot in the middle because pieces have been taken away. Like what used to happen years ago, if you had a gold coin, you'd snip away around the sides just to buy something small. And eventually, you know, the original gold coin that was struck is half the size because 10, 20 people have taken a little snip off that gold coin. And that, I think, and I feel, is exactly what's happening with our entertainment industry. It's slowly being taken away. Maybe 10 years' time from now, you know, we'll look back and think, or people of the future will look back and think, wow, you mean you really used to go into a room, play music, and have 100 people dance? Wow. It may sound crazy. That may sound ridiculously crazy. But who knows? Okay? Who knows? Right. Sean Warren 95. Good evening, mate. Just got my first DJ controller. Getting back into bedroom DJing. It certainly is a tough time for the industry. It is. But again, no one can stop you playing music in your bedroom. All right? No one can stop you having a few family members around and playing to them. All right? Just do it. Have some fun. You know, no one can stop you, as far as I know, going on Zoom and playing to people down the road, so long as you've got them on Zoom. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. You have Twitch. You can do live streaming on Twitch. Don't quote me here whether it's legal or illegal with music content. I don't know. Maybe we'll go back to the days of having a pirate radio station. God knows. Never understood why artists are behind live streams. Yeah, Mark Winter, yeah. Very true. But I don't think it's about the artists. I'm sure they are. I think it's the people who own the rights to the music. They're the ones who've just gone, right, we're just not allowing you to play the music. Because if they did, then everyone would be playing the music and idiots would take advantage and, you know, upload the entire track in a WAV. People would download it and there you go. The artist made no money because it's been pirated. So I do get that. How to get my music shines in streaming industry. That is Andy. How to get my music shines in streaming industry. I can't work that. That's the future, Jay. Yeah, it is. Is D&B easy to mix? Yes, it is. Just count the 3 and the 4, not the 1 and the 2. So 3 and 4, which is the snare beat. And that is going to Zigzag Samsi 1890. How to get my music right. DJ Rick Bonner, the likes of video streaming is the meltdown equivalent of pirate radio. I suppose it is in a way, yeah. Adam Gary, my weekend kitchen party mixes are getting a lot better with all this practice, though. Aaron Gray, well, fantastic. Yeah, you see, make use of the time you have. I've been doing a lot of underground stuff that will be out there soon. I have sort of wasting a bit of time, but I have been doing other stuff as well. Mixcloud is legal, though. The Flash Dog, I do the safety dance these days. We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind because friends don't dance. If they don't dance, they're really no friends of mine. I love it. You like the hair. Again, the hair is because of a video I did a while ago where I mixed The Ones Flawless and Green Velvet Portmanteau Tracks, I Want to Leave My Body. Check that out. It's a really good mix. I love it. It was on vinyl as well. And don't forget, please like and subscribe and donate. All right, please donate. Send us a couple of dollars, please. It would be greatly appreciated because all my content is for free. Yeah, I get a little bit of revenue here, there and everywhere from Google Ads. But, you know, when I make a video 99% of the time, it is for free. And that's it. So, again, time is money, but I enjoy what I do. If I didn't enjoy what I do, I'd have stopped doing this a long time ago. And I've been doing this for like that long. Okay, let's have a look. You've been washing your hair, right? Oh, well done, Mark. Use Distroc if you want your music on iTunes, Beatport, Spotify. Yeah, and that's from Itami101. I am Dobix. Off topic, are you still happy with those QSC tops? I sold them. QSC tops have gone. I sold those a while ago. I've now got some Tresor tops from H&H. Okay, Adam George, absolutely love your channel. I'm about to purchase my second pair of vinyl decks shortly and wanted to know if you had any recommendations on an external recorder MP3 without using a laptop. Right, without using a laptop, you've got the iMix. I'm trying to think of it now. Emix, ReadyMix. But if you wanted to use a laptop, one of the easiest ways to do is use a laptop and use Audacity. Alternatively, Pioneer have got a recording app. It is about $9.99, but then you can plug that in to your laptop and you can record directly on your phone. And it's good proper audio as well. So that's another great way of recording. iRig, there you go, iRig. Recommend Tascam handheld recorder. Yeah, Timothy 101, good idea. DJM Record, that's the one. Lou House, thank you. That is it, DJM Record from Pioneer. Just got the Tascam, mate. Best price quality ratio. EverMix, yes. Also, I think, can you record? No, I mean, Audacity probably is one of the quickest ways. Download it. Make sure you get from the Audacity site. Don't go a third party. Plug your controller in via the record out into a mini jack into your microphone input on your computer. Click record audio, not mic input. And then you're good to go, or should be. Zigzag, iMix in different ways. For DMB, iMix 3, 2, 6, 4 beats before the chorus of the second song, while the first song goes into the breakdown, which is also sometimes 32, 64 beats. Do you know the easiest thing with DMB? It's one of the most formatted genres known to man. All you got to remember, 16 bars, change. 16 bars, change. 16 bars, change. 16 bars, change. 16 bars, break. 8 bars, build. Another 4 bars, build. 2 bars, build. 1 bar, build. Last bar, explosion. Another 16 bars, and off we go again. So just remember the 16. If you can't count drum and bass, and you're thinking 1, 2, 3, 7, 5, 9, just count 3 and the 4. 3 is the snare. 4 is the snare. They're more highlighted in drum and bass. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. So remember 3 and 4. Do you mix happy hardcore, bro? No, I don't. I used to have to listen to a lot of that in the 90s because I used to do PA hire. Personally, it's one of the sort of genres I would prefer not to even listen to. I don't dislike any music, but I would prefer not to listen to that. But I don't mind mixing it. Don't mind helping people, you know, learning how to mix it. But it's not the sort of thing I'd be in my car thinking, what do I want to listen to? Drum and bass, house, deep house, hardcore, happy hardcore. Let's put some happy hardcore on. Not for me. Denon or Pioneer DJ. Pros and cons with all of them. All right. I haven't used Denon enough to say definitely Denon. I have used Pioneer a lot. But, you know, in today's environment, I think, just get used to whatever you've got, because you know the industry is very good at bringing out a new product and telling you if you don't buy it, you're not going to be a good DJ. Well, you need to ask yourself, are you a good DJ with the kit you've got? Do you use all of its functions? If you don't, then why do you want to waste your money, get less than what you paid for your kit, only to part exit to pay more money to buy something else that you're still going to use the same features, and then 6 months later, wonder why you wasted your money when you could have spent that extra on taking the family on holiday somewhere. Industrial dark techno. How about long mixing like Romania sets, 1 5-hour set, 1 hour set, 5 tracks. All right. No, I prefer to chop it up, have a bit of fun, you know, have a mashup. I like raw mixing, okay? I like mistakes. You know, I've said to people, if you have a mix and it's pristine and it sounds as though it's, you know, it's been made by a machine, then it probably has been made by a machine. I like to hear something organic and real. So if you're going to use a laptop and a controller, then if it goes off beat, don't start again. If it goes off beat, put it back in beat, leave it, because it shows you have done it, not the machine. And a manager of a nightclub is more likely to book you if it sounds a bit rough instead of if it sounds pristine, because they're like, yeah, you sync, next, we don't want that. Loving the hair, thank you very much. yes, this is the wig, and this is what I used in a video a while ago. Well, anyway, listen, I'm going to close this up now. Please don't forget to like and subscribe and donate and click that like button and thumbs up and all that sort of stuff. And I hope to do more live streams like this. But, you know, all I'm going to finish here, what I'll finish off with is that as a collective, we can keep the music industry going. We can. We can do it by ourselves. Even if you're in your bedroom, you're by yourself, you're playing some tunes. By definition, by you enjoying the music that you're playing is making you happy, which keeps you going. So if you keep yourself going, you can keep that candle lit, that shining light inside of you, keep it shining. And then once all this is over, you can take that shining light and give it to the people out there and show them that we are worth our weight in gold. Because we are the people that put smiles on unhappy faces. And we're going to continue doing that. Practice and enjoy. Thank you for watching. Boom. Cheers, guys.